Now, we have seen that the water after coagulation and flocculation comes to the filtration unit. Now, there are very fine flock particles, there may be some residual color, there may be some dissolved materials and some microorganisms which will be in the water. So, it's important to remove these residuals from the water. Hence, filtration is done. Here, the filtration unit is composed of a sand layer which is supported by a gravel layer which is further supported by an under drainage system. Over the sand layer, there is a water layer. The water depth may be around, say, 1 meter. Now, the filtration works with under certain mechanisms. The first mechanism is the mechanical straining. Now, the particles which are more than the voids of the sand will get arrested, and thus the removal takes place. This is called as a mechanical straining. The second mechanism that takes place in the filtration is sedimentation. Here, the continuous void space in the sand act like small tube settlers, and very fine particles will settle in these small continuous channels of voids, and the sedimentation also takes place. The third action is a biological action. Here, after few weeks, a sticky layer is deposited on the top of the sand. There are many microorganisms. Here, the organic matter which is present in the water will be oxidized by the microorganisms, and thus the biological action takes place. And the last mechanism, electrolytic action, is also observed. It is about the charge neutralization of the charge of the small particles due to the filter media. Here the charge is neutralized, and thus the particles get trapped. During backwashing, the charge of the filter media can be replaced. So as you can see here, the top water slowly filters through the layer of sand, further it gets filtered through the gravel, and at the bottom there is a separate system to collect this filtered water. Now, the sand which is used for filtration, the depth is around 90 cm to 110 cm overall depth of the sand. The effective size of sand varies from 0.2 to 0.35. The coefficient of uniformity should be 2 to 3. Finer sand will have more bacterial efficiency, but there is a problem of slow rate of filtration. Another important point here, the sand which is used for filtration should not contain more than 2% calcium and magnesium. And the base material on which the sand rests is the gravel bed. So here there are number of layers of gravel. The total thickness of the gravel bed can be 60 cm to 75 cm, and each layer can be of around 15 cm. The size of the gravels which are used in the gravel bed can be 3 mm at the top, 6 to 20 mm in the intermediate layers, and 40 to 65 mm at the bottom layer.